we're quite well prepared for lots of time when there's not much going on, nobody around, and sort of fending for ourselves. So I feel a bit of a fraud, really, because being on here, it's out with what I see every day. I've got no TV or anything like that, so I don't really know what's going on. And I'm not bombarded with it every 5 minutes, which I think a lot of people are. We're very fortunate, really, to be in this situation, you know. Compared to a lot of folk, it's not good, you know, it's not good at all. But, no, we're very fortunate. We don't forget that, you know.
Jason,
inside.
He's a springer. When he decides he wants his walk, it's now. Sorry. This is the lounge. In the lounge right now. This is all for the staff and the people that live here.
We've closed the hotel, of course, and we employ 20 people here and about 15 live in. And so this is their home. I think it's my job, my responsibility to ensure that they remain in their home. And that's what's happening. They're remaining in their home. And we are absolutely lucky, really, really fortunate that we're on an island. And it's not actually closed, but there's only really residents toing and froing. This has really been a bit of a slap to everybody, isn't it? It's really a shock. And it really is. Everything closed. I mean, who would have thought it? Who thought it could ever happen?
I'm Wayne Hamilton, and we're on the island of Inchkenneth. I've not really got a title, but caretake the island, manage the island. It suits me, doesn't suit others, you know. There was all stories of etchings on the glass in one of the bedrooms, in Unity Mitford's bedroom upstairs, and she supposedly put swastikas on there and all this. So we came in with an open mind, and sure enough, that wasn't the truth. I do like remote areas, and you know, the scenery is just amazing, and the community, great community. I can go weeks without seeing anybody, but that suits me. It can also get very lonely as well in the winter time when the weather's really bad and it's dark early. And I'm an ex-Royal Marine, so it doesn't scare me at all. But no, it can be kind of spooky, but. With the windows rattling and the doors creaking and. Go on, say hello to your dad. You okay? You go for a walk. I remember watching an article on coronavirus in China. I live on Mull and not a problem, you know. It sort of grew arms and legs pretty quickly. And I do know that the community has just sort of come together and said, right, we really got to get on with it. Just anything anybody can do, they'll do.
We're part owners of two Scarlet Boats, boys delivering stuff all over the island. The community's rallied round as far as that goes, and it's a good community.
Do you know how many volunteers we've had, is that right?
Yeah, we've got all over the island, we've got 200 to 300 volunteers.
200 to 300 volunteers. That's a lot of donations, yeah, for the food bank as well.
So it brings a tear to your eye. Genuinely, it's very, very emotional.
We're pulling together so much that we will come out this as a stronger unit.
I think we'll come back stronger. I've talked to people in the village when you're lining up to go into the shop at the Co-op that I've never talked to before. All of a sudden, everybody wants to say hi and how are you, and that, and the words keep, I see a lot and hear a lot of stay safe and are you okay?
I'm sure people have made friendships out of this situation that possibly wouldn't have happened had it not happened. And I think that's a good thing, you know, it's got to be a good thing. A bit like a winter storm. Batten down the hatches and wait till it sorted itself out, and we'll be okay, I think. Yeah.